As years go by, fresh memories keep in the minds of those who have continued to witness ADF attacks, and they still live with the effects of the war. Since the 1990s, areas surrounding the Rwenzori region, mainly Kasese, Bundibugyo and Kamwenge districts, are among the places that have been destabilized by Allied Democratic Forces' rebel activities. The activities have seen a number of people lose lives, thousands are displaced, and several others left disabled and wounded. The extended effects of the ADF attack, such as planting landmines in people's gardens, have led to death and exposure of more casualties. During an engagement meeting with people who were disabled during the insurgencies, recounted the events and how they have been coping with the pain and healing processes. Rebecca Bira, aged 36 years, was hit by a landmine in 1997 when ADF rebels attacked her home village in Bugoye sub-county, Kasese district, recounted how she made her fate.
The person picked me and just carried me in his hands when I was seriously bleeding. He also got someone to help him, and that put me on this village bed which they used to carry patients. Then I was taken to the hospital where I spent 3 months.
She further explained the misery she encountered and narrated how she has managed to cope with life.
I lived a sorrowful life until I got a counselor that was a friend to my mother. She told my mother that this girl, you need to tell her to do exercises. So mommy started telling me to do exercises.
With an increasing number of over 64,000 people living with disabilities in Kasese District, Peter Baluku, the coordinator of Kasese People Living with Disabilities, and other authorities say they can't undermine how the previous ADF attacks have also contributed to this number.
Because by now, we have over 200 people amputated. So these people have also again formed them into their own organization, which is in Kilembe Kota here, trying now to do something to survive.
In a move to support people with disabilities, the government, in conjunction with non-government organizations, have set up a number of strategies to empower them economically. Stakeholders have also asked the government to put more focus on protecting the rights of people with disabilities.
Appeal to government that disabilities is not inabilities. These are also human beings and they are citizens.
Story compiled by Samuel Amanyire for the news.